There's something really cool inside of this box that I have to show you. Let's open it and take a look inside. What you can see here is a Lunar Lake SoC. And it's not just a mock-up, it's actually a real chip. I think it probably didn't pass the final validation tests, so it ended up in my hands. The first thing I noticed was how small Lunar Lake is. And I don't just mean the silicon, the entire package is absolutely tiny. Keep in mind, that does include the low power DDR5X memory. You can see the two tiny RAM modules just above the silicon. Lunar Lake comes with either 16 or 32 gigabytes of on-package memory. This means you have to decide how much memory you want when you buy a Lunar Lake based laptop, as you can't upgrade the memory later, at least without expert soldering skills. Let's take a closer look at the chip. Just below the memory, we have the silicon. Lunar Lake isn't a monolithic chip. It actually consists of four different tiles. The large one on top is the compute tile, produced in TSMC's N3B process node. It contains four Lion Cove performance cores and four SkyMount efficiency cores. The XE2-based iGPU, a NPU, and the new memory side cache, which kind of acts like Apple's SLC cache. The small rectangular tile is the I.O. tile, and it does just what the name says. It contains all the I.O.s, such as PCI Express or Thunderbolt. The I.O. tile is manufactured in TSMC's N6 process node. The tiny square tile to the left is for structural support only and has no active function. But the true magic is hidden from us. Underneath the three top tiles is a fourth one, the so-called base tile. It's produced in an Intel node, most likely 22 FFL. This base tile is used for the 2.5D Forwards Advanced packaging, which enables Intel's ultra-fast, low-latency and power-efficient die-to-tie interconnect that connects the compute tile with the I.O. tile. Lunar Lake not only uses the most advanced process node with TSMC's N3B, but also one of the most advanced packaging in a consumer product with Foveros. It's easy to say that Lunar Lake is based on TSMC technology, but the base tile and the packaging are fully done by Intel. If we turn the chip around, we can see the contact pads, not unlike any other CPU. But Lunar Lake isn't a socketable CPU. It uses a BGA package with 2,833 connections. I'm currently at the Lunar Lake launch event in Berlin, and Intel also showed some performance numbers. Since I'm not a benchmark or laptop review channel, I'm not going to cover that. There are plenty of other channels and websites out there covering the performance aspects of Lunar Lake in great detail. And as always, wait for independent benchmarks. What I can say is that Intel didn't fear direct comparison with AMD's Zen 5 Strix Point and Qualcomm's Snapdragon X Elite. From what I saw, Lunar Lake looks very good, not only in CPU and GPU performance, but especially in efficiency. There are two aspects I would like to highlight. First, Lunar Lake reduces package power by 50% compared to Meteor Lake. And the crazy part is that the Lunar Lake package does include the on-package memory, while Meteor Lake uses traditional off-package DRAM. So the actual difference is even greater. The second interesting thing was the core-to-core and CPU-to-memory latency. Meteor Lake had troubles with latency due to the move to a tile-based architecture. And while Lunar Lake still uses tiles, all the important IP blocks, such as CPU, GPU, and memory controller, are on the same tile, which means Lunar Lake avoids any chiplet-related latency penalties. In this sense, Lunar Lake acts more like a monolithic chip. I'm a fan of new technology and of competition. Lunar Lake already hits all the marks when it comes to exciting semiconductor technology. If the real-world benchmarks are as good as Intel says they are, Lunar Lake will finally bring some fresh wind into the thin and light laptop market. I hope you enjoyed this small hands-on impression video. If you want to know more about Lunar Lake, I have an in-depth video where I dive into the chip layout and discuss the architecture in more detail. And with some luck, we might even get actual die shots in the near future. Fingers crossed.